welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be doing a 10 hacks I think every girl needs to know in their life to make their life easier. I tried to think of hacks that maybe not everyone knew about already. I haven't seen many people do that I've accumulated over the years. I just think that everyone needs to know these things, so what's better than sharing all my little hacks with you and making your life easier. So if you want to know 10 simple little things you can do to make your life easier, better, then just keep watching. Alright, so the first hack has to do with your nipples, and I think I mentioned this in a vlog before, but I never actually like sat down in a video and told you guys what I do to cover my nipples. So if you guys didn't know, I do have fake boobs. I got a boob job almost 2 years ago now. I don't really need to wear a bra most of the time. Most of the time I don't wear a bra, but sometimes you just don't want your nipples out and about. I know they oftentimes, at least my nipples, like saying hello, but sometimes it's just not appropriate to have your nipples out. I know a lot of people like that look. I personally am just not someone who likes to have my nipples out. I try to avoid bras at all costs, and with some tops, bras just don't look amazing. And the first thing that I really notice is that when you go buy those conventional nipple stickers, they're like half a centimeter thick. That's just like, hi, come look at me. So what I found were these things on Amazon, which literally look like this. They are paper thin. They are this like mesh material. They have a sticker on the back. Now, another thing I noticed with conventional nipple stickers is that they didn't stay on for the life of me. They just fell off, they peeled off, they weren't comfortable, and you just put it on your nipple and you don't even notice it's there because it's so thin, because the paper comes off in the back and it's just literally just hold your nipple in and doesn't move. It's perfect. They come in packs and they're super, super cheap. Obviously, you can only use them one time, which sucks, but they're really cheap. So if you have issues with your nipples, here's your solution. Okay, hack number two has to do with hemming your clothes. So I don't know about you, but sometimes I buy clothes that I really want to wear that night, but maybe are a little bit too long, or you know, just need to be like tucked in a certain spot, but you don't know how to sew clothing. Because that happened to me last year. I had to go out for an event and the dress, I actually got it hemmed, but it was still a little bit too long and I was panicking because nothing was open. I couldn't sew myself, and so I figured out this little baby. This is actually hemming tape, and this is the dress I used it on. It was a dress from Zara that I got hemmed. It just didn't get hemmed enough. And at the bottom, I have hemming tape. So basically, all you do is go around the bottom of your dress. The bottom looks like it was professionally hemmed. You have to take your time and do it slowly. If you rush it, it's not gonna look good. Also, some materials work better than others, I figured out. But until you have the time to get your dress to the seamstress, this will save you, and it looks pretty goddamn perfect. I mean, I wouldn't wash it and like, you know, have this as a permanent solution, but as a little quick fix, you can't go wrong. It saved my life that night. Sure, I've never seen anyone else do this, but it's a hack to do with Bath & Body Works candles or any candles that you may have. So this is actually my favorite scent. It's called Incense. And basically at the bottom, when you're done with your candle, which I'm so sad, I forgot this one burning yesterday while I was working and I finished the whole candle. When you're done with the candle, you're left with this at the end, and most people just throw this out. You can actually use this these containers. They have a lid. You can use them to store things. And to get this wax part out, all you need to do is pour boiling hot water in it. Let it sit until it cools. Do that a few times and it comes right out good as new, and then you have this little pot. Like, you're paying so much for a candle. I mean, not compared to like other ones, but this trick also works for like Jo Malone candles, any candles. I know my grandma even uses like the little Glade candles. She empties them out and then uses those as glasses, which I thought was really cute. Like, you have so many uses for these little things. So the next hack has to do with razor burns. I know that sometimes when you shave, you can get like little bumps on your legs or your underarms or even your private parts, and it's uncomfortable and it really hurts. I used to get razor bumps on my legs and it's just not fun. A tip for you guys, if you ever want to stop getting razor bumps, is actually to go pick up either a men's aftershave or just spray your perfume, anything with alcohol in it, and you will not get razor bumps. So spray it on your underarms, spray it on your legs, you know, be careful if you're spraying it on your private part, but I promise you, if you do that, you will not get razor bumps. Just think about it, men always put aftershave on their face not to get razor bumps, so put it all over your body. Go buy an inexpensive one at the drugstore, put it all over your body, and there you go. You don't have razor bumps anymore. The next one I want to talk about, I actually don't have with me, but I will insert a picture right here. It is actually pimple patches. When you have an event to go to the next day, or like you need a pimple to be gone in the matter of like overnight or a few hours, you need to try these pimple patches. You will never be so surprised in your life. Honestly, the first time I used them, I was like, what, this is some sort of magic. All you do is you put a little pimple patch on your face, and in the morning, even if your pimple did not even feel anywhere close to ready, the white stuff from your pimple will be on the pimple patch, and your pimple will be almost gone, and you'll be ready to go to your event, get on with your day, and it's really magic, because I don't know what they put in those pimple patches, but you will wake up and you will see white stuff, the white pus on the pimple patch, and it will get rid of it immediately. And not many people talk about that. I don't know why. The next hack has to do with pores. I am someone who has huge crater pores on my face. I think it runs in my family. I don't know, but I have huge pores on my face, and I am always looking for ways to close them up. Basically, the best way that I found is that when you get out of the shower, grab an ice cube and rub it on your face, and your pores, you know, after your shower, they're really exposed, they're huge, they're ready to go. You obviously don't want to go and then stick makeup on that situation. You're going to get clogged pores, it's not going to look very cute. If you rub your face with ice cubes, it will close up your pores and you'll have smaller pores. It's also really good after you do extractions on your face. You don't want to leave an open pore. Close it up with an ice cube. It will shrink it up. It won't get rid of it, obviously, if you have big pores, but it will make them look smaller, and there you go. You will have smaller pores. So this next hack has to do with your hair, and you may know about it, but I just want to talk about it because I do this all the time, and it has changed my life, and I can't imagine doing a ponytail without this. They have eyeshadows, but it's not eyeshadow, I guess it's hair shadow at that point, but they have shadows that are specifically made to make your hair look fuller, look better. And what I do is I actually do this when I have a ponytail, because I don't like seeing like thinning hair around my head, or I have like a weirder hairline, so I will put shadow on to make it more even. But basically all I do is I take a shadow. I like using Activist from the Tartlet and Bloom shadow, and all I do is I go in with a brush, I take off the extra, and just go in. You don't want it to be too much, because then you're gonna look, you know, like you're wearing a wig or something. So don't mind this really messy ponytail, but when you're wearing a ponytail, you can go in and fill in these sparse areas around your face, and it will make your ponytail look thicker, and you won't have all the bald spots. It's more when your hair is like really pulled back. I just did my hair, so I don't really want to pull it back so thick, but look, if you just go in and fill it with shadow, your hair will look thicker. Around your hairline, you can go in if you have a pulled back ponytail. Sticking with hair, this next hack has to do with sleeping and keeping your curls. All you do is take your hair, twist it around itself, twist it in like a bun, and then you take, this is weird, but you take a thong. I don't know why, this is just a hack that I've known for a while, and it actually makes a difference. You take like a lace thong and tie your hair with it on the back of your head like this. Don't ask me why. And it literally stays perfect for you. The next morning, you'll wake up and you won't have to touch your hair again. I don't know why, but it just works, okay? Just try it, you're gonna see. I guess because it's not too thick, but still elasticy. But then you'll wake up, and obviously maybe the pieces around where your head was on the pillow might be a little bit messed up. I don't know, just give it a try. I do it every night, and I wake up, and I don't have to do my hair again. So there you go. This next hack, you've probably already seen it on my channel. This hack really changed my life, so I just wanna let you guys know, if you haven't seen this hack before, All you do is line it up from the corner of your eye to the end of your eyebrow, and you go in and blend it. And when you take out the end piece, you will have the most perfect eyeshadow. Even if you're doing the simplest look, you can do it with intricate look, and you don't have the hassle of putting tape on your eye. It makes such a difference. I do it every single day, and it makes my eyeshadow look a billion times better. So the next time you're doing your eyeshadow, just grab something. It could be this, it can be a cream, it can be a lip gloss that you have. Put it against your eye and try it, and I promise you will never look back, because eyeshadow is not my strongest suit, and whenever I do this, I can pull off some pretty intricate looks. So give it a try. And lastly, the last tip I want to talk about is actually activated charcoal. Now you see everywhere, I literally have one here. This one's called Coco Shine. This is marketed as a natural coconut teeth whitening. It's literally just activated charcoal that's meant to make your teeth whiter. Now, these can go for pretty expensive. This was a bigger tub. It was $9.99 Canadian at my local health food store, and it is activated charcoal. It says on the thing that you can use it to whiten your teeth, and if you don't have the chance to order it online or you want it right away, I know like for me, I want things right away, go to your local health food store, pick this up, and it is the same thing. I get asked a lot what I use to whiten my teeth. I do this every second day, and it really, really works. So you don't need to order it online. You don't need a fancy teeth whitening. So that's it. Those are my 10 hacks that I think every single girl needs to know and use in their life. Everything that I mentioned that I can link down below will be linked down below. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in my next video.